You're watching UNICEF Television. In the dry, dusty morning heat, barefoot kids in torn t-shirts run after an old, deflated soccer ball. They give the soldiers crossing their playground a wide berth. This is in Djamena, the capital of Chad. Soldiers here are everywhere, and in charge. For many of the kids, soldiers live an ideal life. They have smart uniforms, dark glasses, and usually a scooter or at least a bicycle. Nobody tells them what to do. Many kids here want to be soldiers, and until 2007, many kids here could become soldiers, joining any one of a myriad of armed groups. But following a cooperation agreement between UNICEF and the government, Chad has withdrawn over 800 children from groups involved in armed conflict. Those children have entered transit and orientation centers and receive vocational training in a bid to stop them rejoining for economic reasons. At this UNICEF-supported transit and orientation center for demobilized child soldiers in downtown N'Djamena, young boys deal with their experiences of war through art. Images of guns and fighting dominate. It's all they know.
I joined the National Army when I was 12 and fought for them for 4 years. And then I joined the rebels. I was a soldier of war.
At the center run by Care International, in addition to the art therapy, the boys are able to draw on 24-hour counseling to help them readjust to life outside the war zone. They often arrive with violent, aggressive tendencies and suffer sleep disorders. But with time, social workers are able to gain their trust. They are given literacy and language classes, receive 3 meals a day, and receive health care, as many arrive with injuries sustained while fighting. The surrounding community is also involved in the center's activities and is an important part of the reintegration process. UNICEF's advocate for children affected by war, Ismael Beah, himself a former child soldier in Sierra Leone Civil War, visited the center.
Whenever I visit such places, you know, like the center we went today, there's a bit of sadness, but there's also a bit of, I feel like I can bring some kind of assurance to some of the young people there because I've been in a similar situation. I came to one of these centers very uncertain of what the next step of my life would be and where I am now, so that they can understand that there are possibilities that lay ahead.
The use of child soldiers globally is widespread. Around 250,000 boys and girls under the age of 18 are currently involved in more than 30 conflicts worldwide. Some children are abducted or forcibly recruited. Others are driven to join by poverty, abuse, discrimination, or revenge. In Central Africa, thousands of children have been recruited by rebels and government forces in conflicts across Chad, Sudan, and the Central African Republic. Demobilizing child soldiers is one thing, but ensuring they don't return to fighting for economic reasons is something else. Ishmael visited a workshop where demobilized and rehabilitated child soldiers learned to become mechanics. Throughout N'Djamena, workshops, tailors, and even hotels are taking such boys under their wing, giving them a salary, independence, and a better chance at a normal life. Back at the center, images of war eventually give way to images of hope. Robert is training as a mechanic, and instead of guns, he now sketches motorcycles. It's his way of leaving behind the past and looking to the future. This is Guy Hubbard reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to www.unicef.org. Unite for Children.